Hi friends, here in this video what I will explain is the motorcycle charging system and the headlight system and taillight system. A motorcycle have this type of coil in its alternator or magneto, which have two parts. One is the low voltage side and the other is the high voltage CDI. So this wire winding is specially made for CDI ignition system, capacitor discharge ignition system, and this one is specially for the battery charging and head and tail light. So there are two circuits in this low voltage side and one circuit in the CDI side. So CDI is okay, we will explain in some other video, and already I explained in many videos and I brought some videos on my channel where you can find in good information. So this one, the low voltage side, it is containing two circuits, which is one for the battery charging and the other for the headlight and tail light. So here is the circuit diagram. The circuit diagram will also explain each and everything regarding this system, and also I have a regulator rectifier unit which is used normally on motorcycles. And here is, you can see this 3D diagram for this same one. So this is the same unit. I will explain each and everything in this video. So here you can see how the system works, very easy. Here is the alternator for the motorcycle, which is this one, and this has a few wires. One is yellow and the other one is white. Here it is shown as black and red, but unfortunately white we cannot show over here on this page. So this black and red, you can see the wire color is not mattering, because the wire color is, you know, insulation, anything can be, but the internal is the copper, and that has the very same color for each and every wire. So this white wire, this is the same, this one, and the yellow wire line, which is this one, is the same, this one. So this yellow wire is going to the head and tail light, and this one, which is the white, it is going to the battery charging. So these two wires, and the third wire you can see here is the green. Green is the ground. You can see this is the ground. Ground is very much important, and ground is also connected inside. So the other wire, which you can see over here, this is for the CDI. So CDI we are not going to discuss in this tutorial or video, but instead I will explain in detail the ignition system, the charging system, as well as the headlight and taillight system. So headlight and taillight system, one thing is alternator, other things are switches which are there for the headlight and taillight. There is a switch, and the next thing is the regulator. Regulator is very much important. As you can see, this is the regulator 4-pin device. Here are the 4 pins, 1, 2, 3, and 4, like this. Here 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this fourth one is the ground. This is the system ground. This is going to the battery ground, and this is very much important. In some motorcycles it is removed and then the motorcycle is giving more charging, but unfortunately that more charging is destroying the battery, as well as it is destroying the headlight lamp also, or the tail light lamp also. So this thing is, and then here the first I will explain the headlight wiring. So headlight wiring is looped somewhere from the alternator, and it is going to one pin, which is the second pin over here in this regulator. This pin, it is connected, and here is the shunt regulator. This regulator has two regulators inside the circuit. You can see, as you can see, this is transparent. So there are two circuits inside, two regulator circuits inside. One is the series regulator and the other is the shunt regulator. So this one is the shunt regulator. This is coming in parallel, so that's why the name is shunt. So this wiring, you can see, it is going to the light as well as to the unit, this regulator rectifier unit. And then the other thing is the battery charging system. So this regulator is regulating in shunt way, that if voltage is high on high RPM, so that current is bypassed to the ground from this, by this regulator or rectifier unit. So this is the way it works. And the next thing is this charging system. So the charging system contains a series regulator inside. There is a series regulator and a rectifier also. For the headlight, there is no need of rectifier, so rectifier is not there in such a unit, but a rectifier is there for the battery charging only. So first the power is rectified, the AC power, which is fed from the alternator. This is converted to DC, and then that DC is fed to the series regulator. Series regulator is inside, and that series regulator is giving power to the battery. So here this first terminal is connected to the battery, positive this post. So the battery post positive is connected to this first terminal, and also this positive post is going to the starter motor. If starter is available in the motorcycle or motorbike, so it is going directly to the starter motor, as well as through a fuse this power is fed to the ignition key switch also. So ignition key switch is distributing that power to the rest of the motorcycle systems, like sideway turn indicators, audio system, or any other system which is there. For that also, this power from the battery is used. So some people, they are complaining that their motorcycle is blowing headlight and taillight bulb. So what is the reason is, if the ground is disconnected, this one ground is disconnected, then it will do the same. I mean to say, the lamps, lights will be blown. Or if this wire is disconnected, this yellow wire is disconnected from here also, it will burn the lights. And the other thing is, if the regulator itself is going defective, so this thing will happen. So these things are, and hope you people learn a lot information from this video. If you learned something from this video, give a big thumbs up and subscribe on my channel. Press on bell icon so you will get notifications for each upload. Thank you for watching.